Charlie has recently been discharged from a mental health care hospital where he was treated for depression, something he has been suffering from since childhood. It is time for him to transition back into normal school, but he is shy and doesn't make friends easily, and so he is nervous and apprehensive about the start of school. On his first day at school, he is teased by his classmates but likes his English teacher, Mr. Anderson. He doesn't really make any friends and ends up attending a football game by himself. He notices Patrick from his shop class as the only senior in a class of freshmen. Patrick notices Charlie and asks him to sit with him and his stepsister Sam. Charlie is immediately attracted to Sam. When he gets home, he witnesses his sister Candace being hit by her boyfriend. Charlie feels strongly about domestic abuse because of their Aunt Helen, but Candace persuades him to keep what he has seen a secret from their parents. Shortly after, Charlie finds himself at homecoming standing alone watching everyone dance. After seeing Sam and Patrick dancing at homecoming, Charlie dances with Sam and Patrick and soon after goes to an after party with them. At the party, they introduce him to some more of their friends, Bob, Mary Elizabeth, and Alice. Charlie eats his first pot brownie and amuses everyone with his sudden wit and insightful observations.
You guys felt this carpet?
This carpet feels so darn good.
Okay. Charlie, what do you think about high school?
High school? Bullshit. Cafeteria is called the Nutrition Center. People wear their letter jackets even when it's 98 degrees out. And why do they give out letter jackets to marching band? It's not a sport. We all know it.
This kid is crazy.
Mary Elizabeth, I think you're really going to regret that, you know. Sure. Haircut when you look back at old photographs. I'm really sorry. That sounded like a compliment in my head.
God, that's kind of true.
Shut up.
You can't even be mad at him. Look at him.
Bob, did you get him stoned?
Come on, Sam. He likes to just look at him.
How do you feel, Charlie?
I just really want a milkshake. Sam. You have such pretty brown eyes. The kind of pretty that deserves to make a big deal about itself, though. You know what I mean?
Okay, Charlie. Let me make the milkshake.
What a great word. Milkshake. It's like when you say your name over and over again in the mirror, and after a while it sounds crazy.
So I'm guessing you've never been high before.
No. My best friend Michael, his dad was a big drinker, so he hated all that stuff. Parties too.
Well, where is Michael tonight?
Oh, he shot himself last May. Kinda wished he left a note, you know what I mean?
Once the party has gone on, Charlie goes looking for the bathroom. Once upstairs, he sees Patrick kissing Brad, who is the star of the school football team. Patrick tells Charlie that Brad doesn't want anyone to find out about their relationship, least of all his father, because he would disapprove. Patrick asks Charlie to keep it a secret. Later, Sam tells Patrick what Charlie told her about his best friend, and they welcome him into their group of friends.
Everyone.
Raise your glasses to Charlie.
What did I do?
You didn't do anything. We just want to toast our new friend. You see things, and you understand. You're a wallflower. What is it? What's wrong?
I didn't think anyone noticed me.
Well, we didn't think there was anyone cool left to meet. So, come on, everyone. To Charlie.
On their drive home, they hear a song that none of them know. So Sam instructs Patrick to drive through the tunnel so that she can stand up in the back of their pickup and dance, whilst the music is blasting out loud. Soon after, Charlie sees Sam dancing with Craig, her boyfriend, and can't help but get overwhelmed with jealousy and sadness. The following day at school, asks his teacher,
"Why do nice people choose the wrong people to date?"
Are we talking about anyone specific?
Well, we accept the love we think we deserve.
Can we make them know that they deserve more?
We can try.
Charlie is helping Sam study for her SAT, and as Christmas nears, they go to a party. Another nice holiday happening is that their group participates in a secret Santa gift exchange. On the final night of the exchange, Sam gives Charlie her gift, a typewriter. She thinks that it will help him because he wants to be a writer. They start to chat about their first kisses, and Charlie tells her that he has not had his first kiss yet. He has never kissed a girl. Sam, meanwhile, tells him that her first kiss was from her father's boss, who was molesting her at the time. She wants a different for Charlie. She wants his first kiss to be from somebody who loves him, and then she kisses him. Charlie's birthday is on Christmas Eve, which always makes him think about his Aunt Helen, who died in a car accident on Christmas Eve after picking up a present for him. He is still hugely troubled by his aunt's death, and when he takes LSD at a New Year's Eve party, he has flashbacks to the night she died. He is found by police passed out in the snow. Charlie goes to the Sadie Hawkins dance with Mary Elizabeth, and afterwards they go to her house to make out. She declares that he is now her boyfriend. Charlie doesn't want to be her boyfriend and has no interest in her but continues the relationship, because he has no idea how to break up with somebody. At another party, during a game of truth or dare, Patrick dares Charlie to kiss the prettiest girl in the room.
Let's think, Charlie.
Truth.
How's your first relationship going?
It's so bad that I keep fantasizing that one of us is dying of cancer so that I don't have to break up with her.
Charlie? Truth or dare? Hello?
Dare?
Okay. I dare you to kiss the prettiest girl in the room on the lips. And notice I charitably said girl and not person, because let's face it, I'd smoke all you bitches.
Oh, that's true.
Bob Nelson.
Oh, that's fucked up.
Mary Elizabeth, I'm so sorry.
He kisses Sam, which enrages both Sam and Mary Elizabeth. After all, when challenged to kiss the prettiest girl in the room, it is traditional to kiss one's own girlfriend. Patrick advises him to give them both some space whilst things cool down. Weeks go by and still his friends ignore him, which plunges him back into his depression, and to make matters worse, his flashbacks to the night of his aunt's death are continuing to haunt him. A few weeks later, Brad comes to school covered in bruises. Brad's father caught Brad and Patrick having sex, which explains the bruise on Brad's face at school that day. But Brad claims steadfastly that he has bruises on his face because he was jumped in the school parking lot. Brad calls Patrick a faggot after the two get into a fight in the school cafeteria, and Brad's friends get involved, beating up Patrick until Charlie intervenes and knocks them all to the ground, but blacking out in the process only to become aware again as he's going to the office. Which leads to reconciliation with his friends. As graduation nears, Sam is accepted by Penn State and her friends throw a leaving party for her. Charlie helps her pack. Sam asks him why he never asked her out, and one thing leads to another. They kiss, but Charlie pulls away when Sam touches him on his inner thigh. He claims that nothing is wrong and continues to kiss her, but she is concerned that something might be wrong. The following day, as he watches her leave for school, he feels very uncomfortable and, once home, has a breakdown. And flashes back to his Aunt Helen touching his thigh in the same way Sam had the night before. He calls Candace and tells her that it's his fault his aunt died, because maybe he wanted her too, and the universe manifested what he wanted. Candace sends the police to the house, worried that Charlie is going to harm himself, and when they arrive, he blacks out. Charlie wakes up in the hospital. His physician explains to his parents that Charlie was being molested by Aunt Helen and that he repressed the memory, because he blamed himself for her death. When he is discharged from hospital a few weeks later, Sam and Patrick take him out to one of the group's favorite restaurants. They drive into a tunnel and Sam tells Charlie that she has found the song that they were playing the last time they all drove through the tunnel, Heroes, by David Bowie. Charlie climbs into the back of the truck to think about life, and kisses Sam, standing up and screaming as they exit the tunnel. For the first time, he feels truly alive.
We are infinite.